Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam ma ba'd. Ayyul habati fillah. Continue on in our study of Imam Muqbil Bin Hadi Al-Wadi'i, Allah yarhamuhu. His treatise entitled Hadhihi Da'watana wa Aqidatana. That this is our da'wah, this is our prop, our call, and our aqidah, our belief, or our creed. We reached the portion of the treatise where Imam Muqbil, rahmatullahi alayhi, said, نُؤْمِنُ بِأَنَّ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ سَيَرَوْنَ رَبُّهُمْ فِي الْآخِرَةِ بِلَا كَيْفِ. Imam Muqbil, rahmatullahi alayhi, said, and we believe, again illustrating his aqidah and creed and minhaj, which is in agreement with the aqidah and creed of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. He said, we believe that the believers will see their Lord in the hereafter without asking how. Meaning that we don't ask how this will happen, but we understand this from the Quran and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we believe in that. And that is the minhaj of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah with regard to the Nusus in general. But especially those nusus or those texts that deal with the sifat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we have taslim, that we accept them as they are in the Quran and the Sunnah. And we don't ask how. We don't say, oh, well, how does our Lord nuzzle? How did he estow ala al-arsh? How does he rise above the throne? We don't ask this, but we believe that he rose above the throne. We believe he descends to the lowest heaven every last third of the night, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in a sahih hadith, a sahih Muslim, that your Lord yanzulu rabbuna tabaraka wa ta'ala kullu thuluth al-layl al-akhir fa yaqul. That verily your Lord descends every last third of the night and says, and then he adds to the rest of the hadith. So what we learn from this and is the qa'idah of Ahl Sunnah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends in a manner that suits His majesty, and we don't ask how. And we believe in those nasus. And this is what Imam Muqbil was saying. And he was talking specifically, of course, that the believers will see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of judgment. That this is a fadl that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has extended to the believers. And in this regard, أَجْمَى الْأَنْبِيَاءُ وَالرُّسُلُ وَالصَّحَابَ وَالتَّابِعُونَ لُهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ عَلَى قَوْلٍ بِرُؤْيَةِ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ فِي الْآخِرَةِ وَشَذَّ عَنْهُمْ مَنْ لَا خَيْرَ فِيهِ مِنْ أَهْلِ بِدَعٍ. The Anbiya, the Prophets, عليهم أفضل الصلاة والسلام, and the Rusul, the Messengers, عليهم أفضل الصلاة والسلام, and the Sahaba, رضي الله تعالى عنهم أجمعين, and the Tabi'un, those who follow the Sahaba, rahimahumullah, jami'an, and all of them who follow them in righteousness, you know, having the same creed, having the same manhaj, having the same manners, having the same methodology in understanding Islam and practicing Islam. They all are united or are in agreement or have consensus that the believers, or that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be seen, the Almighty, in the hereafter. And of course that this refers to the mu'mineen, the believers. And very few, there's a shadh opinion, meaning that there's an opinion which goes against the, not just the majority, but almost all. It is just a very rare, odd opinion. That, and there's no good in these people who have this opinion, because they are from Ahl Bidah. So meaning, only Ahl Bidah refutes that the mu'min are from the Muslims. Only Ahl Bidah say that the believers will not see their Lord in the hereafter. This is due to their deviance. وَلَا خَيْرَ فِيهِمْ. And there's no good in them. وقال الشيخ رحمه الله تعالى باب إثبات رؤية المؤمنين لله تبارك وتعالى يوم القيامة دل على ذلك الكتاب والسنة وإجماع عليه أهل السنة والجماعة من الصحابة والتابعين ومن سار على ما هم عليه وسأذكر بعد الدل على ذلك لبيان ما كان عليه اعتقاد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وصحابته كرام وجمهور السلف. So Imam Muqbil rahmatullahi alayhi said, and he entitled a chapter in his book Al-Zilazil, Al-Zilzal. He said the chapter affirming that the believers will see Allah the Almighty and Majestic on the Day of Judgment. So this was what he entitled his chapter, his chapter in the book. And then he mentioned the Quran and the Sunnah and what Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah have consensus upon, and the Sahaba and the Tabi'een and those who follow them in righteousness all hold this as their aqidah. You know, all of this is supporting evidence that the believers will see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the Day of Judgment. And may Allah bless us to be of those to have that fadl, ameen, ya rabbil alameen. And then he said, and I will mention some of the evidence regarding this in order to show that this was the creed of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companions and the majority or the jamhur of the Salaf of this Ummah. And some of the adilla illustrating that is the ayat in the Quran in Surah Al-Qiyamah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, in Kitab al-Kareem, وُجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ نَاظِرَةٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهَا نَاظِرَةٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Qiyamah, He said, faces will be bright that day looking at their Lord. And the way that this is evidence, the wajd dalala in this ayat is that this shows that there will be faces on the Day of Judgment, bright radiant faces that will see their Lord. And of course, this is in reference to the mu'mineen, in reference to the believers. And some of the other evidences which illustrate this for us, and this is adilla that shows that the believers will meet their Lord on the Day of Judgment. قال الله تعالى قال الذين يظنون أنهم ملاقو الله in Surah Al-Baqarah. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned Surah Al-Baqarah in other places as well. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the Almighty said, He said that those are the ones who will who believe that they will meet their Lord, meaning they will meet their Lord on the Day of Judgment. And in another verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fi kitab al-kareem, wa'lamoo annakum mulaquhu. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, also in Surah Al-Baqarah, that, and know, you know, and this is in the commandment imperative form, wa'lamoo annakum mulaquhu, and know that you will meet him. Meaning you will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these are also some verses which illustrate for us that that the believers will meet their Lord on the Day of Judgment. And they will see their Lord as was illustrated in the other ayah. And the understanding also that can be derived, as the ulama have deduced from the nasus, from the ayat we already met, or in Surah Al-Mutaffifin, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كَلَّا إِنَّكُمْ عَنْ رَبِّهِمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ لَمَحْجُبُونَ, that nay, أَنَّكُمْ أَنَّهُمْ, verily they, on that day, will be prohibited, there will be a hijab that will prohibit them from seeing their Lord. From that day they will be concealed, on that day they will be concealed from their Lord. So this ayat is referring to the disbelievers, those people who disbelieve in Allah wa Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Islam, and that they will, on the day of judgment, they will be, there will be a hijab between them and their Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, as this ayat in Surah Al-Mutaffifin illustrates. And the mafhum of this ayah, the mafhum mukhalifa, meaning the understanding that can be deduced from this ayah, which gives us the opposite from this verse, because since this verse addresses the disbelievers that they will not see their Lord on the day of judgment, what is understood from that ayah is that the believers will see their Lord on the day of judgment. فيه دلالة على أن المؤمنين يرون ربهم يرون ربهم يوم القيامة وفضلوا بذلك على الذين هجبوا. Here, and this was from one of the Salaf of this Ummah, that this ayat, we gain understanding from this ayat that the believers will see their Lord on the Day of Judgment, and this is a great fadl or blessing and aspect of superiority that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give to those who believe over those who disbelieve, those people who have a hijab prevented from them seeing their Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. They will not be able to see their Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is a fadl, this is a ni'mah, this is a great reward from Allah to the believers that they will see their Lord on the Day of Judgment. And those are just some of the evidences. Also in Sahih al-Bukhari, Imam Bukhari rahmatullahi alayhi said, he entitled the chapter, Bab Qawlillahi ta'ala, وَجُوهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ نَادِرَ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهَا نَادِرَ, as we already mentioned the ayat. So Imam Babahari entitled the chapter in Sahih al-Bukhari called the chapter of the statement of Allah the Almighty, where he said, and faces will be radiant that day, and they will see there will be radiant faces and they will see their Lord. Then he mentioned a hadith. He said, حَدَثَنَا عَمْرُ بِنْ عَوْفْ قَالَ حَدَثَنَا خَالِدِ بِنْ هَشَيْمِ عن إسماعيل عن قيس عن جرير قال كنا جلوس عند النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذ نظر إلى القمر ليلة بدر قال إنكم سترون ربكم كما ترون هذا القمر لا تضامون في رؤيته. الحديث أخرجه مسلم. So in this hadith that's in Bukhari and Muslim, in it, some of the companions were sitting with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu majma'in. And he sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they were looking at the moon. And he sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Verily, you will see your Lord, just like you are looking at this moon, and there is nothing that clouds your sight, you know, nothing that prevents you from that." Meaning that you will see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala very clearly on the day of judgment if you are blessed to be amongst the mu'mineen, amongst the believers. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all with the ikhlas, with the bat, and bless us to be of the mu'mineen, to see Him subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.